Hi, I'm Ken. This year I'm riding the Great Divide mountain bike route. I'm out here with Keith, aka Old Timer, whom I met on the Pacific Crest Trail. Old Timer's 70 years old, a Vietnam War vet, and he's hiked the AT, the CDT, and the PCT, making him a triple crown hiker. He's also biked the Trans Am 76 from the east coast of the USA to the west coast, and then on completing that, he rode up to Glacier National Park in Montana, making it a total of 5,000 miles. In Grants, while I was editing the last video from our hotel room, we witnessed a sandstorm. Then, we made the decision to ride to Cuba using the Chaco alternate due to the scarcity of water that we experienced on our last section.
Story goes, if you never slow down and you never go, well, there's a great big world just waiting to behold. But you're still lying around, and the days fly by like a cloudy sky, and you're glued to the TV, never blinking an eye, and the world will keep changing, time passing you by, but you're just waiting to die. So won't you come outside? There's a beautiful world just waiting for you. Seem like it's all just a waste of time sometimes, but you gotta decide, are you really alive, or are you just waiting to die? Just waiting to die.
All the videos I've seen on the Great Divide mountain bike route make it look like great fun all the time. But the truth is, it's hard. It's hard because you've got to make the miles, to find water, to find a campsite, to make town. You've got to keep biking, even though you don't want to. And there are good days, and there are bad days. And there are good times, and there are bad times. But it's important to remain positive throughout it all.
Once, well then I told you twice, you never win a gun battle if you're bringing a knife. And the truth that doesn't hurt if you spelled out right. But it's just too easy to give up the fight, to just place the blame, scream the name, point a crooked finger, it's all the same. It's just a dirty little game that we keep playing, full of dirty little lies and a dirty little brains. And it's hard to maintain when we're locked away, time to open up the door and come out to play. Because the sun's in the sky and it's a beautiful day, the world is wide open, hey, what do you say now? Won't you come outside? Well, there's a beautiful world and it's waiting for you. And I know it might seem like it's all just a waste of time sometimes, but you gotta decide, are you really alive, or are you just waiting to die? Won't you come outside? Well, there's a beautiful world and it's waiting for you. It might seem like it's all just a waste of time sometimes, but you gotta decide, are you really alive, or are you just waiting to die?
That final descent into Abiquí was the most fun I've had on this trail thus far. fun riding hard and fast. Trying to get into Abiquiu on time to meet a friend for dinner that evening. I had dinner with an old college friend in Abiquiu, and early the next morning, I did a quick resupply stop.
Oh yeah.
From Abiquiu, we were deciding if we should take the pavement alternate because of the rain, or take dirt. We decided because the days were so hot, the trails would dry out, and so we opted to take the dirt, which is the main route, and we didn't have any regrets.
Yeah, pretty good. Dry.
Take to the sky. Open up your eyes and see how far you get in just one day. Day to the sea. And open up your heart and see
last
how far
gate.
You get to
glory.
And it's a big old world we're
how's
living
that?
Now. And how mighty it can be. And all this time I pictured you standing next to me. So we could go find things we'd never seen. Pictured you standing next to me. So we could go find things we'd never seen.
No. No. Go away.
I was really happy to get to Salida. My tent had been falling to pieces and I'd been trying to repair it. But it was not doing well, and at Salida, I received the new tent that I had ordered